सो नेक्स्ट विल गो फॉर मास डिफेक्ट एंड बाइंडिंग एनर्जी. सो फर्स्ट वी अंडरस्टैंड द मीनिंग ऑफ मास डिफेक्ट. सो मास डिफेक्ट मीन्स द डिफरेंस इन मास ऑफ कॉन्स्टिट्यूएंट ऑफ द डिफरेंस इन मास ऑफ कॉन्स्टिट्यूएंट्स ऑफ न्यूक्लियस एंड एक्चुअल मास ऑफ न्यूक्लियस. नाउ कंसिडर ए न्यूक्लियस विथ एटॉमिक नंबर जेड एंड मास नंबर ए. सो इट हैज जेड नंबर ऑफ प्रोटॉन्स एंड ए माइनस जेड नंबर ऑफ न्यूट्रॉन्स. सो टोटल मास ऑफ प्रोटॉन विल बी जेड एम पी एंड टोटल मास ऑफ न्यूट्रॉन्स विल बी ए माइनस जेड टाइम्स एम एन. सो मास ऑफ कॉन्स्टिट्यूएंट्स ऑफ ए न्यूक्लियस ए जेड एम पी प्लस ए माइनस जेड इंटू एम एन. Let actual mass of this nucleus is m. Then this difference in mass is called mass defect. Here delta m is mass defect. Z it is atomic number. A mass number. Mp mass of a proton. Mn mass of a neutron and capital M this is mass of nucleus. So this difference in mass is called mass defect. Then we'll go for binding energy. So binding energy equal to delta m into c square. Now delta m is zmp plus a minus z into mn minus m whole into c square. So now understand the meaning of binding energy. When a nucleus is formed, its actual mass is slightly less than the total mass of its constituents. So when a nucleus is formed, some mass is converted into energy and it is released from the nucleus. This amount of energy is called binding energy. Now in the other way we can say that the energy required to break the nucleus into its nucleons and to separate them to a large distance, that is called binding energy. The energy required to break the nucleus into its constituent nucleons and to separate the nucleons to a large distance is called its binding energy. This binding energy binds the nucleons inside the nucleus. Next one is binding energy per nucleon. So binding energy per nucleon equal to delta m into c square by a. So delta m equal to zmp plus a minus z into mn minus m whole into c square by a. So what is its meaning? It is the average energy required to remove a nucleon from the nucleus. It is the average energy required to remove a nucleon from the nucleus. Now, if delta m is in a mu, we know that 1 a mu, it has an energy equivalent of 931 mega electron volt. So binding energy will be delta m into 931 mega electron volt. and binding energy per nucleon, it will be delta M by A into 931 mega electron volt when mass defect is in the form of AME. Now, binding energy per nucleon represents nuclear stability. More the binding energy per nucleon, more is the stability of the nucleus. Then, packing fraction. It is equal to isotopic mass minus mass number by mass number. Isotopic mass minus mass number by mass number. So, we can say it as mass defect by mass number or mass defect per nucleon. This is called packing fraction. If packing fraction is negative, nucleus is stable. If packing fraction is positive, nucleus is unstable. So, this is the graph between binding energy per nucleon and mass number A. Now, we already know that if binding energy per nucleon is more, then the nucleus is more stable. If it is less, then the nucleus is less stable. Now, we can divide this graph into three parts. In this region, A is between 20 to 140. Here mass number is greater than 140 and in this region mass number is less than 20. Now from the graph we can observe that binding energy per nucleon is high when mass number is between 20 to 140. So nucleus in this region are more stable. Now, binding energy per nucleon is maximum for iron 56. So, this is the most stable nucleus. Now, we'll go for heavy nuclei when A greater than 140. So, heavy nuclei have less binding energy per nucleon. So they are unstable. Hence, heavy nuclei split into lighter nucleus and become stable by emitting large amount of energy. When A greater than 140, the binding energy per nucleon decreases, so heavy nuclei are unstable. Hence, a heavy nuclei splits into lighter nuclei and becomes stable by emitting large amount of energy. This process is called nuclear fission. Similarly, when A less than 20 for lighter nuclei, they also have less binding energy per nucleon. So, they are also unstable. Hence, lighter nuclei fuse together to form a heavy nucleus. and emit large amount of energy. This process is called nuclear fusion. But if the graph were smooth, the graph will go through this path. Now there are spikes at helium, carbon and oxygen. So helium, carbon and oxygen have relatively higher binding energy per nuclei. So these nuclei are relatively more stable, which helium 4, carbon 12 and oxygen 16. They are relatively more stable because they have relatively higher binding energy per nuclei.